My name is Gabriela Donis. I am from El Salvador. I work as a librarian in a university. I like my profession very much. I like to help people with the goal that they have the information they are looking for at the moment they are looking for it. I'm here to talk about the future of libraries and librarians. The trend that I identified is the fact that the library evolved to be a virtual service for the public. That is to say that libraries went from providing their services in person, the book lending, reading rooms, reference service, due to the change that took place in the whole world because of the threat of the lethal virus COVID-19. To provide the service via internet or via virtual. Thanks to the reach of today's technology, we can do that. It was possible to reach the home of each of our users through cell phones, desktop computers, tablets, laptops, and even a phone call. The implications for the library field in the next 10 years will be positive, since the way in which libraries provide service for the community that they serve has changed. The virtual service will in fact be from now on the main way to be in contact with user. It will be the main bridge that will bring the response to the information need to different types of user in all areas that are required. This in order not to stop providing its valuable services that are the key to access to the information. The action that the library field can take in response to this trend is the virtualization. Henceforth, all forms of work, developing virtual collections, websites, and all kinds of support in virtual format to offer content to users, even using social network as channels to promote the use of digital resource that every library own. Thank you for this space. Thank you for the opportunity to participate in this World Library and Information Congress focused on the Americas, and let's continue working so that libraries will always be the foundations of knowledge and facilitators of information.
Hi everyone, I am Adriana Ferrari. I am the Vice President of Brazilian Federation of Library Association and Institution, FEBAB in Portuguese. I am also a Director of Florestan Fernandes Library at University of São Paulo. I'm a member of IFLAS Public Libraries Committee, as well the Latin American Caribbean Division. I haven't been an activist in the library field since 2007. I strongly believe that the future of libraries must engage advocacy, make a consistent strategic advocacy now is paramount to keep the libraries relevant. Libraries must be recognized as essential for the people in their communities. To accomplish this, libraries around the world show work in the line with the 2030 agenda and the other international pacts aimed to address inequality. Knowing how politics work and doing advocacy are the key for redefining the role of libraries in the social fabric. COVID-19 pandemic increased inequality, drastically affecting our way of life. We should question how to promote libraries in more challenging contexts where starvation, diseases, or lack of access to basic infrastructure exist. Librarians' focal point shall exceed their libraries, as occurred with some initiatives done during the pandemic using technology to be present in their communities. Right now, with the gradual opening society, both virtual and impersonal means shall be used to further connect to people. Librarians need to listen carefully to understand the community's problems in order to find solutions together and, when needed, propose them to the local government. To guarantee the existence of public policies that follow the growing demands of libraries, the presence of librarians in strategic positions is also necessary. We need librarians as councilmen, mayors, congressmen, senators, and why not even presidents. That means young librarians must be encouraged to follow a political career. No one is better than yourselves to make a case for the importance of libraries.
Hello, my name is Dr. Ray Pan, a standing committee member and the information coordinator of the Continuing Professional Development and Workplace Learning section, known as CPDWL. I am a librarian and educator. I am the Education and Outreach Manager at the Hoover Institution Library and Archives at Stanford University in California, United States. Thank you for the invitation to share my ideas with attendees regarding trends for the future in the Americas. The trend I see is thinking about and expanding how we serve our communities of users who have been historically marginalized, excluded, and/or underserved. By thinking about the biases that we hold in our library system, services, policies, and resources, we need to hold ourselves accountable and address these areas to improve and expand library services to such communities, such as people with disabilities, racially and ethnically underrepresented groups, and/or all gender identities. 10 years from now, it'll be 2031. The implications of the library field is in the next decade include expansion of new opportunities of engagement, stories that reflect inclusion and diverse communities' experiences, and opportunities to diversify the profession at large. When we reframe our services and resources to support underserved communities, we also inspire new opportunities in the profession. In addition, we need to recognize that there is inherent systemic racism in the profession itself, particularly in Western countries, and there is a critical need to identify opportunities to diversify the profession, to reflect such communities. Otherwise, if we don't address these issues, we lose such opportunities to grow and expand the profession in new ways, and we will lose value in connecting with these communities. An action plan that I propose in the library field is to review and document how they serve such historically marginalized, excluded, and/or underserved communities. This includes climate and war refugees, LGBTQ patrons, people experiencing homelessness, people who are incarcerated, people with no or limited broadband access, and racial and ethnic minorities. When I say documenting the services, it could mean collecting and examining data, policies, and doing a complete audit on how they support such communities and think of ways to improve through partnerships with organizations supporting such communities or allocating new funding to support such a cause. Showcasing it on the website, having conversations with such communities, promoting better practices through presentation or publication, sharing what libraries and library workers are doing, particularly in the World Library and Information Congress. This is a very difficult task to do, so I recommend having an internal audit on your policies, collections, services, and holding conversations with library staff and with community members to plan and conduct an outreach strategy effectively, taking it seriously and intentionally. Another action step would be to offer such positions as leadership to internship roles to members from such specific communities, and building and sustaining opportunities in engaging services and diversifying the library team. This is a challenging undertaking because we want to avoid tokenism. However, opportunities focused on supporting such communities need to be considered, and having a conversation and through recruitment and retention are critical components to seriously consider. Thank you for your time and consideration. Enjoy the rest of your conference.
Hola, mi nombre es Lucía Bello. Soy bibliotecóloga, naturalista y coordinadora de la Coordinación de Bibliotecas Públicas de la Región de Los Ríos, que depende del Servicio Nacional del Patrimonio Cultural del Ministerio de las Culturas, las Artes y el Patrimonio de Chile. Hace un tiempo fui una de las personas que respondió a la encuesta sobre tendencias del futuro que tendrán las bibliotecas y que ha sido liderado por IFLA. A partir de lo que he apreciado en este último tiempo, reflexiono que las bibliotecas tienen una estrecha relación en los aspectos socioambiental, económico y tecnológico, que no siempre están visibilizados o de los cuales no se tiene conciencia de su importancia. Sin embargo, hoy más que nunca se hace necesario tener en consideración algo que ya se manifiesta en los Objetivos de Desarrollo Sostenible de la Agenda 2030 de Naciones Unidas. Las bibliotecas se insertan en comunidades, las que se ven fuertemente afectadas por problemas ambientales, de los que es necesario educarles para mitigar los impactos. Por ello, se deben generar espacios de encuentro con la comunidad que habite esos diversos territorios, articulando a las y los especialistas del ámbito científico, ecológico, entre otras áreas relacionadas, que eduquen y entreguen información que permita a esas comunidades conocer lo que les sucede, crear conciencia y así tomar mejores decisiones que beneficien a todos y a todas a través de un desarrollo económico armónico y sostenible, donde las bibliotecas se permitan colaborar e implementar instancias de apoyo para el emprendimiento local, donde el acceso a las tecnologías actualmente es una limitante a la hora de querer llegar a todos y a todas, por lo que la inclusión no está asegurada. Es por esta razón que también se requiere propiciar el fortalecimiento y o promoción de políticas públicas que garanticen tanto el acceso a la información como a las tecnologías que lo permitan. Quienes trabajamos en el ámbito bibliotecario tenemos una gran oportunidad para ser protagonistas, articulando y gestionando todo aquello que esté a nuestro alcance, sin olvidar que trabajamos para las comunidades conformadas por personas que confían en sus bibliotecas y quienes allí laboran. Un abrazo y muchísimas gracias.
Hola colegas de todo el mundo, estoy muy contento de estar ahora con ustedes acá participando del Congreso Mundial de la IFLA en su versión virtual. Mi nombre es Jonathan Pleites, soy de El Salvador y estaré compartiendo más en relación a la tendencia del futuro, particularmente su vinculación con la industria 4.0 o bien conocida como Cuarta Revolución Industrial, que mezcla vanguardistas técnicas de producción con sistemas inteligentes que integran las organizaciones, particularmente la biblioteca y las personas. A continuación, les presentaré este estudio que se ha desarrollado en los últimos 4 años para presentar la transformación de las bibliotecas escolares en centros de recursos para el aprendizaje, especialmente su relación con los Objetivos de Desarrollo Sostenible. Si bien históricamente hemos conocido a la biblioteca escolar como un espacio que reúne diferentes recursos, no ha sido suficiente. La pandemia actual nos ha venido a demostrar que debemos de repensar los modelos de aprendizaje y con ello las formas de acercar la información al ciudadano de la información. Por ello, esta investigación está centrada en desarrollar un modelo propuesto que incida a la calidad educativa, donde converjan diferentes componentes que ayuden en cuanto a la innovación, a la tecnología y a la modernización de los espacios. Este estudio se ha centrado en desarrollar características específicas en cuanto a la implementación de diferentes actividades, componentes, estructura en relación con el acceso a la información y la educación de calidad. También dentro de este modelo lo que se busca es desarrollar y relacionar los objetivos de desarrollo sostenible en su vinculación e incidencia. Este modelo propone además contar con espacios idóneos para nuestra comunidad, colecciones que respondan a las necesidades, recursos que estén alineados a esas necesidades. No solo recursos impresos, sino teniendo una variedad de recursos que estén disponibles para toda la comunidad. Estos recursos deberán de estar debidamente organizados en cuanto a diferentes componentes. Estos componentes, acá por ejemplo, se muestra en perspectiva un modelo en relación a tener en un solo lugar todas esas características en cuanto a su organización, al personal, a los servicios y los ODS. Acá podemos observar una perspectiva global de esto. También deberemos de modificar, actualizar y ajustar los servicios que actualmente se disponen desde la biblioteca escolar. Un modelo que mezcle las características en cuanto al uso de las tecnologías de la información y comunicación, en cuanto a la transformación de las tecnologías para el aprendizaje y el conocimiento, y la implementación de las tecnologías para el empoderamiento y la participación ciudadana. Este modelo además reúne, entre otras características, la comodidad, la fácil movilización y la flexibilidad. No sin antes relacionarlo con la gestión del CRA en su vinculación de una sólida y efectiva administración, su vinculación a responder esas necesidades educativas y cómo se pueden ampliar sus características por medio de redes y alianzas estratégicas mediante la implementación de acciones específicas que incidan en tener colecciones acorde a esas necesidades, el transformar los recursos de la información y el de acercar por medio de servicios de calidad a nuestros usuarios. Finalmente, muestro este diagrama que permite identificar su relación con el bibliotecario, el maestro y los estudiantes, incidiendo positivamente a la calidad educativa. Si quieren recuperar la investigación completa, les animo a que me puedan escribir, no importa el idioma. Muchísimas gracias por la invitación y nos vemos muy pronto. Hasta luego.
Hi, I am Maribel Alvarado Acuña and I want to share with you trends for the future in Latin American libraries. I am head of Library System Area in Pontificia Universidad Católica Library Systems. I am also a professor in a master program in Information Processing and Management. Trends for the future in Latin American libraries include open science movement and new services in libraries based in spaces and tools. What are the implications in the next 10 years for our libraries? Open science involves academic libraries, not only sharing research information, but also managing research data repositories and open access publications, supporting citizen science and training users in tools and related best practices. Librarians will need to lead efforts to develop new skills in this area to collaborate with researchers as competent partners. The increased use of electronic collection and decreased use of physical collection is a global trend. New services required by users are emerging. Fewer bookshelves and more maker spaces are changing and challenging the design of services and spaces in libraries. What are the actions that the library can take in response to open science? To learn about and acquire skill in open science structure and tools, including open access publication, citizen science, and research data management. To teach, design aid to introduce and engage authorities, researchers, and community with open science. To offer services and tools that support open science, such as an institutional data repository and research data management services. Be part of institutional open science initiatives. Regarding the new services, libraries can to explore current user needs for spaces and tools, to redesign and create new spaces in addition to study rooms. For example, learning, recreation, labs, construction, and workspaces. To offer resources that support user work, such as software, hardware, equipment, tools, musical instruments, and other materials. To manage tools and workflows that allow us to maintain and improve these services. To evolve, libraries must be able to offer dynamic spaces and services according to the needs of their users. Thanks for your attention.
Hi there, my name is Rodrigo Castaneda and I'm a librarian and a PhD candidate for social and political science at the UNAM in Mexico City. First of all, I want to thank the organization team of World Librarian Information Congress for this opportunity. In the last 2 years, I have seen a growth in the use of cloud services and the use of teaching of code and early ages. The implication, the way I see it for the librarian fields, is to make shorter the flow of information between users and the information of itself. That being said, I identify 3 purposes. First of all, include programming and software developed in studies programs, either way librarians or information science studies. The way I see it is that if we can make our own cloud services on our own interface, we can make more accessible and more amigable from all our users. Second, we need to think librarians as a more aggregators in the era of digital information. What I'm trying to say with that is that we need to ubicate the informations that are in a database, in other database, in other services that are useful for our users. And maker, like they are our own, and to be able for all the all our searches areas, all the implications that make the classifications, the categories, and the labels to make more accessible the information for all the users. And third, we need to make the mechanisms of information access more able for people or groups in vulnerable situations, considering the implications that bring with it. For example, indigenous people, immigrants that don't easily have in the early day basis the internet access. We need to make and really consider that vulnerable situation as one of the more difficult things for information access. We need to really make the mechanism for them to have the information to provide with the instruments and the tools to make a decision for their lives. Thank you. See ya.